Yeah, give me the MSX cartridge.
Over here, Snake. Over here, Snake.
Hey, it's a guard with a big gun. Oh, no, it's Big Boss.
Big Boss, you're alive? Snake, welcome to Zanzibar Land. I knew you'd come back to me. I came to get rid of the nightmares I've been having for the past 3 years. The nightmares? They never go away, Snake. Once you've been on the battlefield, tasted the exhilaration, the tension, it all becomes part of you. Once you've awakened the warrior within, it never sleeps again. You crave even bigger tensions, bigger thrills. As a mercenary, I think you would have realized that by now. You care nothing for power, money, or even sex. The only thing that satisfies your cravings is war. All I've done is give you a place for it, given you a reason to live. I never would have made you for such a hypocrite, Big Boss. You saw those children, didn't you? Everyone is a victim of war somewhere in this world, and they'll make fine soldiers in the next war. Start a war, fan its flames, create victims, then save them, train them, and feed them back onto the battlefield. It's a perfectly logical system. In this world of ours, conflict never ends, and neither does our purpose, our raison d'etre. So there's plenty of job opportunities, is that what you're saying? On the battlefield, you and I are valuable commodities, but back home, we're nothing but dead weight. If we're lucky, we might get the attention of some two-bit journalist from a cheap tabloid. You and I are doomed to remain here until we die like dogs on the battlefield. I've only got one fight left, to free myself from your grip, to rid myself of these nightmares. Big Boss, I will defeat you. It doesn't matter who wins here, our fight will continue. The loser will be liberated from the battlefield, and the winner will remain. And the survivor will live out the rest of his days as a soldier. It doesn't have to be that way. I'm not like you. I love life. Very well, Snake. I'll release you from your suffering. As your former commander, I'll do you one last favor and push you out of your misery. I don't need any more favors from you. Really? And just how do you expect to beat me in your condition with no weapons? Never give up. Fight until the end. Always believe you will succeed even when the odds are against you. Those are your words, Big Boss. Even I make mistakes from time to time. Snake, this will be our final battle. Let's end this once and for all.
Alright, I want to keep Boss on the opposite side of the map, if I can. Oh, God damn it! Walked right into that a good old sulfuric acid. Don't make me fight Metal Gear again. Okay. Alright, let's skip the dialogue, or the monologue. It's basically a monologue. Skip all this. Get to the fight. And not step in the sulfuric acid. Alright, got a lighter. Halfway there. How do we keep Big Boss on the far side? But that motherfucker, he hears my footsteps. A lacquer spray made from dimethyl ether and LP gas. This can says, do not use near open flames. Metallic gray in color. Good to know. Lighter. An ordinary dollar store lighter. Its use is unknown. Now we have a flame punch. Let's go and get this motherfucker. But we need to get him on the other side of a wall so his bullets don't hit us. Yeah, we'll play Ring Around the Rosie. I will now eat rations. Now Yeah, that's right, you were on fire.
Snake! It's not over yet. It's not over yet. It's not over yet. Stay.
Freeze! It's okay. It's me, Snake.
God damn it, Holly.
Did I scare you?
That was a close one. So what's going on? What are you doing here?
You said it yourself. Stay alive and we'll meet again sometime.
So I did.
Ugh, that uniform was too tight in the chest. My titties are too big. Ah, I feel much better now with my massive kajongas. Just yaboing out all yabo. Here, I stole this gun from the enemy. You can have it.
Yeah, I can see how it'd be hard for a woman to use. With their dainty little fingers, and they can't help because I'm a aging dinosaur of a sexist. Thanks.
So it's all over now, right? Snake?
No, I still have one more job to do.
You can't be serious.
I'm dead serious, Holly.
Snake, no, you can't.
Want me to call you a cab?
Oh my god, that wasn't funny, Snake.
This is Snake. Come in, Charlie.
This is Charlie. Go ahead, Snake.
I've got the cartridge. I'm ready to return to base. Making my way to the rendezvous point now.
Roger that. I'll meet you there. Any passengers?
Just one with two stonking huge tits. Blonde with a cute face.
Sounds like a dream. Over and out.
Holly, we gotta run as fast as we can to the rendezvous point. Think you can keep up?
Is that a proposition, Snake?
I'll take that as a yes. What the hell is taking you so long? We're going to be here till Christmas!
This is Charlie, I'm 10 kilos out from the rendezvous point. Hold tight a little bit longer. Over and out.
Hurry!
Was I not supposed to kill everyone? Well, I can't leave.
Damn it, I'm out of ammo.
Snake. It's the chopper, we're saved.
Charlie, you're late.
Kept you waiting, huh? Sorry, man, I didn't want to disturb you two lovebirds.
Think we'll be home in time for Christmas?
We'll be home in time for dinner, Snake.
Let's go, then. I'm looking forward to Christmas dinner. I'm sick of these rations.
Snake, what's your fixation on Christmas? Literally has no relevance to any of this.
That was Metal Gear 2, Solid Snake. After wasting almost a full hour trying to backtrack to a place I could not reach, and having to reload an old save, thank God I had an old save. Don't know if I'd have the wherewithal to start a new game just to get to that point. So, I know I'm not the first person to go back and play these in order of release, but I want to say, like, one of my favorite YouTubers, or he's not even, I don't want to just call him a YouTuber, because I feel like he's contributed so much more to, like, the video game industry zeitgeist, but good old George Weedman, Super Bunny Hop, definitely want to echo what he said about this a few years ago. The gameplay of this game is so much more refined than Metal Gear 1987, and it feels good to play. Feels like there's much more you could do when it comes to sneaking. You don't just run around a corner, you can, like, hide under things. Really focuses on different levels of being able to sneak, such as certain territories that have elevated walkways, as well as hidden overhangs that you can crawl underneath. But those are the refinements you'd expect to see in a sequel. Like, I mean, if you make a game and it's successful, the assumption is if there is a sequel, the sequel will take everything from the first game and improve upon it, which this, at a mechanical level, absolutely did. But something this game did, aside from all that, was it didn't just improve mechanically, it improved, I want to say fictionally, like in its literature, the storyline, the plots. Like, this was made in 92? Early 90s, like extremely early 90s. And the plot, like the story that they were trying to tell with this game, they wanted this to be cinematic. And they did it with the tools they had, which means nowhere near enough tools to make it genuinely cinematic. So how do you make something that can't be cinematic? You have to use the tools of the game. Little things like punching a wall, a guard hears it, starts to circle around to see, what was that noise? Little things like that really ratchet the tension. And it's kind of nuts that, like, in the era of the NES, they were doing things like that. Whew, I've got a lot of thoughts about this, but I also don't want to just... Oh,
good work, Snake. Have you thought about coming back? The nightmares have stopped, and I'm a free man. I see, that's too bad. By the way, that cartridge, is it really the one Dr. Marv hid his plans in?
Why don't we open it and find out?
No need for that. The cartridge I brought back is Dr. Marv's, no question about it. Just put it in the MSX. All right, here it goes.
VRAM, 01 KB. Nothing's happening. Flip it backwards, Keo Marv.
What on earth? Of course, Snake was right. There's no doubt this is Dr. Marv's cartridge.
What are you talking about? I don't see anything.
Here, look closer. Dr. Marv left his signature on it. Right here, says Keo Marv.
I see it now. It's written backwards.
This is going to do the world a lot of good. Dr. Marv's last performance.
He really loved games, didn't he? From the bottom of his heart.
Dr. Marv was entangled in a pointless political game, and now it cost his life. But the game he left behind will save us all. Right, Snake?
Snake? Where'd he go, Colonel? Snake's gone!
Snake? Where's he off to now?
Snake? Snake! He promised to take me out to dinner! How low can you go? How low can you get?
Hind D. Colonel, what's a Russian gunship doing here?
You're getting there soon. That's the game. Huh. Interesting. Well, I'm not going to get into boss survival tonight. It is 11:45. I need to be up. I don't have to be up early. But I do have to work tomorrow. So, the few of you that dropped by, Decoy Octopus, newcomer, thanks for swinging by. Definitely helped me out with that final puzzle of needing a B3 ration with cheese to get the insta-kill mice to come out of their hole. Very appreciated. And public nuisance, Octavius. Spouting nothing but obscenity and things that are irrelevant to this marathon about games that we haven't touched yet, so they don't exist, because that's how we're doing this. I'm going to pretend they don't exist, except for Metal Gear Solid 1, because it's so good. And that was a lot of fun. I'm going to need some time to stew, because
people have already said almost everything there is to say about the Metal Gear saga. And I agree with, for the most part, there are people who like to break things down, people who like to imagine grander visions of intention, which I feel is kind of unrealistic. Even though Kojima is a madman, you see pictures of that man's working space, his working areas, like his desk. Every desk he's ever had while like directing a game is insanity. It's like 4 feet tall of books end to end, and you know he took the time to read those books because he brings such minute detail that doesn't even contribute to a story other than make the world seem more real. So I've got to think about what I have to say about this, because while I agree with a lot of things I've heard, and I've read a lot of published Metal Gear analytical, or not criticism, but yeah, Metal Gear analysis, like published analyses, I have read a few. Heather Alexandria, also very, very good. I'm going to have to go through and just double check all their stuff to make sure I don't say anything that I don't want to be gratuitous. I don't want to be a voice saying nothing important. Because I think one of the most important things about the Metal Gear series isn't like, is it cinematic? Yes. But I feel the true glory, like what makes these games more than the sum of their parts, is that they can never be truly cinematic. Instead, they use the systems of the game in ways that require you to do things beyond the game to truly understand. Which I'm sure, I know I've listened to the Kojima Frequency podcast. They've talked about it too. Kojima's all about meta. Be meta for everything. Everything is meta. But also, I feel like that's a funny joke. It's not wrong. But that is something to celebrate in a way. But it's, you can't just say being meta is good, because then you get the meme. Everyone's like, whoa, that's meta. We'll figure it out. We'll figure out what we have to say about the importance of these games and what it means to be greater than the sum of their parts. But we're about to hit 4 hours, which means this week's Metal Gear Monday was a success. We've defeated Metal Gear 2 Solid Snake, and next week we will be beginning my first Metal Gear game. Came out when I was 10 years old. And I'm an old ass man at this point. 1998, I was 10. I rented Metal Gear Solid because cool spy. I was getting into James Bond. James Bond's super cool. I like spies. Here's a game where you play as, is marketed as playing as a spy. Played it. It's a lot more than about being a spy, but it's cool as hell. But, yeah, we'll be starting Metal Gear Solid next week. So I just want to thank you all again for swinging by to say hi. Oh, wait. Hold on. I'm doing this wrong. I'm doing everything wrong. Big screen. Big screen so you all can actually see my face. Also, I wore this last week as well. My Tokugawa Heavy Manufacturing t-shirt. Forgot where I bought it, but I love it. Also, oh my god, I need to find a way to play Police Knots. Police Knots would be really fun. Because I've only seen it. I've never played it. And I know that there's an English fan translation floating around somewhere. Anyway, I'm all over the place. We're at 4 hours. We beat Metal Gear 2 Solid Snake. We did terribly, but it's fine. It was a fun game. We torched Big Boss. And then he exploded, but he didn't really explode because maybe he exploded. The other games don't exist. We haven't gotten to them yet. Big Boss is dead for good. Snake's hitting on someone. cut maybe, and won't stop talking about Christmas. Game's over. Get back to you next week on Metal Gear Solid. I'll see you all then. I've had a lot of fun, and this has been Metal Gear Monday.